everyone, and welcome to, I guess, Hope Summer Repertory's first interview slash performance of the summer. Today we have with us a fan favorite of Holland and Western Michigan. Don't laugh at that. Not funny. That's true. That's about as true as it gets, Marcus. We have Marcus Martin with us. Marcus, how you doing today, my man?
I'm good. How are you, man? I'm hanging in there.
I'm good. So I'm in New York. Can you tell everybody where you're at?
Yeah, I'm back home in Akron, Ohio, about 30 minutes outside of Cleveland. Spending some quality time with my mom, watching a lot of Law and Order.
Law and Order.
Listen.
Employing New York actors for 30 years, Law and Order did.
Love it.
And so what school do you go to? You were at where?
I am wrapping up online classes at Baldwin-Wallace University.
And for those of you who don't know, Baldwin-Wallace is one of the elite musical theater programs in the country.
Yes, sir.
And we have been lucky enough to have Marcus with us before, and obviously was scheduled to be with us this summer. Marcus, what were you going to do for us this summer? It was no small task what you were going to do. So what were you what were you contracted to do, my friend?
Lenny was crazy enough to ask me to be Don Quixote in Man of La Mancha this summer, and I was really, 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 really excited to take that on.
Don Quixote, a small one, small role. Marcus likes the small roles. He doesn't like the big roles. He likes the supporting roles. And we were going to see him as Baraccio in Much Ado About Nothing as well. He was going to show off some Shakespeare, some chops. Not happening now, and us being in the world we're living in. I wanted to see, as we think about, all the things that could have been, what was one of the main reasons that you wanted to come back to Hope and that you were looking forward to coming back to Hope, if you were indeed looking forward to coming back to Hope?
No, I was so excited. Really, the community, the support that HSRT gets from the community. I mean, the way they rally around us, it's the reason why that place has been around for almost 50 years now. You know, the way everybody supports us, and even just going to a cafe to get breakfast and, the owner being like, hey, I was at the show with my family last night. Your bagel's on the house. You know, just those those interactions that you get around the community really, really make Holland a special place. And yeah, I'm really going to miss that.
Yeah, for me as well, it's one of those, as you're prepping to come to New York, and we'll talk about that in a second as well. One of the great things about going back to Holland, and this would have been my third summer there, is that sense of community that, you get to know everybody really quick, and you get to see people that saw the show when you're having breakfast, like you said. And they really do support the company so much. When we did make the announcement, the outpouring was tremendous in terms of condolences and things of words of kindness about how hard the decision was and how disappointed people were. And one of the main reasons why we decided to do these interviews and to let them see who was coming and have people like you pop on and do a little singing as well, is to see the kind of people that are coming to Hope now, the kind of talent we have and people like you. So with that being said, you and I have talked, and it's kind of like a secret inside story for everybody who's watching. Marcus will be back. He's going to go get famous first, and then we'll have him come back to Hope. But when you think about Hope, what would you say to, people your age or people in your situation graduating from big programs, small programs? Why do you think Hope Summer Rep should be on their radar as an option for them to spend the summer with?
Hope Summer Rep is such a special place to work because it's not just a performance contract. It really is an educational experience. Like every, rehearsals with Lenny, rehearsals with Lenny is a masterclass. Every rehearsal you get with Lenny is a masterclass. I remember my audition to come, my first time, season 47, was like, he did this whole acting exercise with Hannah on Hart. So it's more than just that you go to rehearsal, you do the show, you go home at the end of the summer and go back to your life. and not really changed at all. It's a special experience all around.
Yeah, you know, meeting Marcus and seeing him audition and then courting him. Marcus auditioned and then had an offer in his email that evening. And that doesn't happen that much. Marcus has turned into a good friend and a great talent, and we were lucky to have him the first year round when he played the Lion in The Wiz, which he won a Wild Award for. You are an award-winning actor.
yeah.
And then also brought the house down in Godspell with All Good Gifts, which is still one of my my favorite. I gain goosebumps. You can't fake goosebumps thinking about that moment in that show with you singing that song. From season 47, what was your best memory from that?
Oh gosh, I would say doing The Wiz. I'm gonna be completely honest. You know, it's a big deal to African American culture. It's huge for us. And so I was like, is anybody gonna be in the audience that looks like me? Coming out almost nightly after the shows and seeing young African-American kids that were just absolutely blown away and wanting to hug us and get our autographs. That was a really, really special experience. And some of them, it was their first time seeing theater. So it was just really, really special.
Yeah, it was special on many levels. It was a beautiful show, an amazingly talented cast. You couldn't even rattle off. You said you have to name the entire cast, you know, but, you know, with Maya Lagerstam and Brandon Wright and Chaz, yeah, who's another audience favorite, man, and Maddie Jones. Oh, my Lord. Yeah. We were really blessed that summer in a lot of ways.
Shout out to Marcus Johnson.
Marcus, what a beautiful job directing. We brought him back last year, and he directed a gorgeous production of Truth as well, which had Chaz in it, too. So. Yeah, that makes me happy to hear you say that. That's a big deal to us. As you know, it's a mission of mine and Anne's, and Reagan's. You know, the company is really trying to be at the forefront of that. And so to hear you say that's very special. In our unique situation now, with COVID and, you know, the world, being a scary or uncertain place right now. What are you doing in your spare time, which we all kind of have copious amounts of? What are you doing to pass the time other than online classes? What are you doing to stay sharp?
Yeah, I'm really viewing this as an opportunity. You know, of course, it's not a convenient situation. It's an unfortunate situation, but I'm using this as an opportunity to put myself in a position to come out on the other side of this successful and okay, put myself in a position to be okay once all this is over. So I've been doing some living room concerts on Instagram Live, just singing, you know, trying to put out content, trying to, you know, just keep my performing skills sharp. I've got a virtual talk show I'm working on. I'm gonna be talking with some people from different backgrounds. Trying to stay in shape. I'm still doing voice lessons. Mm-hmm. I'm working on trying to use this time wisely for me.
Right. You know what? You kind of burned through it, and I'm not going to let you do it. Plug your concerts. Plug your concerts right now. Tell people how they can see your concerts and how they can go about to having your living room concerts with your mom and you, where you sing. He goes through the musical theater. You could make requests. And as you should, he has his Venmo, his PayPal, his, you know, whatever way you could send him money, he has it all there, and mom's working it. It's really a great production. And if you don't know his mother, what a beautiful lady. So tell us how, and she should be your agent. So don't worry about your New York agent, just hire your mom. But go ahead and tell us how we can see your concerts. Go ahead.
All right, so my Instagram at MarcusM_330, and that's where I do my concerts. Not every Friday night, but most Friday nights I'll probably have a concert. I'll be taking requests on the spot, so you can just drop in the comments what song you want to hear. And if I know it well enough to sing it on the spot, which usually I pretty much do for the most part, I'll sing it for you. I'll do some a wide range of genres of music. I'll do everything from Motown to Golden Age musical theater to rock and roll to boy band music. I mean, just have a good time. Just bring some joy and laughter and dancing and music just from my living room to yours, because it's what we all need.
Yeah, it is true. I having watched them, it is truly what we need. So thank you for doing that. The last part before we get to your performance is I'm going to rattle off some questions a la every famous talk show host, late night style. So he doesn't know these are coming. So this is rapid fire. Are you ready, Marcus? They're easy. Woo! I think so. I kind of know them, but they're fun. Dream role.
All right.
What's your dream role?
Oh, man. The Genie in Aladdin.
Genie in Aladdin. What's your favorite show you've seen all time?
Favorite show I've seen all time, Memphis, the musical.
Memphis, the musical. Where was it at? Broadway?
Yeah. It was my first Broadway show.
Everybody remembers their first Broadway show.
Yeah.
Favorite show you've been in of all time? You don't have to say your host show. What's your favorite show?
Oh, man, favorite show I've been in. I'd say just for nostalgia, I'll say Joseph in The Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat.
And you played?
Joseph.
Of course. He likes the small roles. Marcus. Your most embarrassing moment on stage?
Oh, man. I would have to say this was... I was doing show choir my eighth grade year. I did competitive show choir, which ranges the entire school year. So from June to May, we do competitions. And eighth grade was the year that my voice changed. And so we put the show together in June of summer going into eighth grade, and I was fine. It was a female solo from Freak Flag, from Shrek the Musical. But over the course of the year, it got a little bit harder for me to sing. And there was this competition, and I just totally cracked, and it was tragic. It was tragic.
So, and then the last question, and this does not have to be theater related. What is your proudest moment?
My proudest moment. My mom, who you referenced already, she's amazing. She's incredible. She's had such an impact on my life. I love her so much. I wouldn't be the person I am without her. She's always said my entire life, you know, success on stage and in your career would be great. I'd be proud of you. You could go and win a gazillion Tonys and break Audra's record, and that'd be great. But I would be more proud if I found out that you left this world better than you found it. And I took that with me to college. And I noticed my sophomore year that... And I've always been very, very active at my school. I'm a social media ambassador. I'm a tour guide. And so I kind of have a platform. People kind of listen to what I say. And I've kind of had this, like, image on campus as kind of being, like, the unofficial mascot of the school. My sophomore year, I noticed that our music conservatory didn't really do anything to reverence Black History Month, which is interesting to me because we have all these music history courses, and we talk a lot about music history, but so much of the history of music is rooted in Black culture. And so I wanted to use my platform and do something instead of just complaining about it. I wanted to change it. And so I created this weekly tribute to a different person of a different genre, African-American musician that impacted music. And, you know, I made these weekly videos, and I got our African-American professors from the Conservatory involved, and people liked them and people saw them, and people from programs across the country saw them, and, you know, parents and prospective students saw it, and it made them want to, you know, have their kids come to the school. And it was really, really impactful, and that really, really made me proud.
Yeah, you should be proud of that. Good parents make good kids. And that amazing woman that is your mother made an amazing young man. You have a bright future, sir. I have no doubt. When the storm passes, we will see you in Holland again. I just ask that when you win your first Tony, that you thank me second. I'd like to thank my mom and Lenny Banovez, or I'd like to thank God and Lenny Banovez. You just have to do that, and everything will be great. Marcus, you know I love you, man. Thank you for your time. I really can't appreciate it enough. I've said this to you before privately, and I'll say it publicly. It's a shame that we won't be able to see you play this role yet. We will see you play this role at some point, but until that time, here is Marcus Martin singing, Tira, singing The Impossible Dream. And hope to see you all soon. Maybe we'll do some more of these. Marcus, take care, my friend.
All right. We love you, Holland.
To dream the impossible dream, to fight the unbeatable foe, to bear with unbearable sorrow, to run where the brave dare not go, to right the unrightable wrong, to love pure and chaste from afar, to try when your arms are too weary, to reach the unreachable star. This is my quest, to follow that star, no matter how hopeless, no matter how far, to fight for the right, without question or pause, to be willing to march into hell for a heavenly cause. And I know if I'll only be true to this glorious quest, that my heart will lie peaceful and calm when I'm laid to my rest. And the world will be better for this, that one man scorned and covered with scars still strove with his last ounce of courage to reach